Hello everyone, my name is Mitra Swain. I welcome you all to the UNC Digital Classes. We are studying Introduction to Business, and in today's class, we are going to study about the qualities of a successful businessman. So first, we have to understand that what are those qualities which make a very common man a very successful businessman. Okay, so we are going to discuss about what are the traits or characteristics or the qualities. It is written that modern business is very challenging and it is very complex, which require physical as well as your mental quality of a high order. Some of the important qualities that make a successful businessman are described below. So it is written that nowadays it is very much complex in the worldwide, and it is not very easy that we will start a business and there will be no competitors and we will be the number one businessman. Okay, so the competition is very tough, the world is very challenging, so we have to be that tactful and we have to be prepared. So what are the qualities that are going to push us to become a very successful businessman are as these points. So the qualities which can make a man, a common man, into a successful businessman can be, first, it is your wide knowledge. It is the knowledge or the vast knowledge of the entrepreneur. Next is initiative. Next is physical energy, foresight, business morality, dependability and consistency, ability to cooperate, self-confidence, aptitude for research and analysis, and winning personality. We are going to study about all of the traits in more detail in the coming slides. The first point in the qualities of a successful businessman is your wide knowledge. To be successful in business, a person must have wide theoretical and practical knowledge of the economic as well as the non-economic environment. He should possess above average intelligence and skill. In addition, he must be well informed about the technological development and marketing condition. It is written that the businessman must have a very wide knowledge about how to operate a business or how to start a business, about all the economic, means how to earn profit and how to deal with the customers, how to satisfy them, how to build good relationship, all about the environmental situation. He must have a very broad knowledge, and with that he must have a knowledge regarding the technological development and marketing condition. When I am saying that I have a wide knowledge, it means when it will be needed, means at the proper situation, I can make a good decision. And this knowledge can be improved with proper training, with proper education and experience. Means day by day, this knowledge is going to be broader and more deeper. Okay. So, sound common sense is very essential to be more successful in business. Next point is your initiative. Initiative means the ability to start or the ability to create something new. Okay, the leadership, this can be also an initiative. This means that you must have the courage to start. So, by originality of thought, a business can create his own opportunity. He must have the capacity to make quick and correct decision. It is not like that I will take a very long time to take a decision, and it is also not like that I will take a very quick decision which will be wrongful to my organization. Okay. So it is very much important to keep a balance between the time I am taking to make a decision and also that decision will be effective for my organization. Okay. Because opportunity come and also goes in a very rapid or in a very fast way. Okay, if we will not be that prompt, then the opportunity will also pass from our hand. So the businessman must have the capacity or the ability of the mental alertness. We can say that the constructive imagination, that how effectively we can think, or the ambition, the judgment, etc. Okay, so we will use all of these things to create our own path, or how we are going to create our new opportunities. The next quality in a very successful businessman is the physical energy of that owner or of that person. Okay, so a business means you are the owner and you have a lot of thought or you have a lot of plans, and those plans are very long term. So we cannot say that I have a mindset or I have a plan and there will be no hurdles or there will be no constraint and I will be successful in a very fraction of second. Okay, this is not going to happen. So I have to keep patience, and for that I must have possessed the physical energy. So business involves long hour of hard work under pressure. Means there are a lot of pressure, mental, physical, sociological, psychological, every type of. Means it is from all the quarters we are going to face hurdles. Okay. So a businessman must have an abundant of physical and nervous energy. Means his mental ability must have to be strong, and also he physically have to be strong. He must possess the capacity to work hard on a sustained basis, because if he will not sit or if he will not work for a long time, see, the employees are for a very routine period. Means they will come at a very particular time, means let's say 10 a.m. and they will go to home at 6 p.m. But it is not that fixed for the entrepreneur or the manager or the employer. Okay. So they may sit for days, or we can say they work for weeks also. They sleep at the office sometimes. Okay. So it needs that much of physical strength on the part of the entrepreneur. And it also say that he must not lose heart when hurdles arise. He must have the determinants which will be very strong to push himself to work for a very long time. Okay. Because plans are not going to be work out in a very short period of time, because our plans are very long time. We have a vision that after 10 years we want to be there. Okay, so for that we have the courage of conviction or the drive or the physical energy and also perseverance. Okay, I hope this point is clear. Now we are going to move to the next slide. The next point is saying the foresight. Foresight means the ability to see the future. It is not like the horoscope, or it is not like fortune telling. Okay, so we are saying that we have the capacity to dream. It is written that modern business is subject to quick change and uncertainties. So as there are a lot of competition and the market is very much complex, so changes is very rapid in today's world. So a successful businessman must have the breadth of vision to forecast and to look into the future. He have the capacity that what he want to do or what he want to achieve in the next 10 years or next 15 years, he must have a very clear cut idea about that. And his ability to forecast accurately will determine that the quality of his business planning. Means if we could not determine then after 6 months or 7 months, what we want to achieve. Okay. What is your ambition? You have to fix that. And if you could not see that what you want to be or what you want to achieve, then your foresight is very weak. Okay. And if the foresight is weak, a businessman could not be that much of successful. And here we are saying that a good businessman is always ahead of its time. Means हम कहते हैं ना कि वो समय से आगे चलता है. वी आर लिविंग इन 2021 एंड द बिजनेसमैन इज थिंकिंग और लिविंग इन द एरा ऑफ 2030. ओके, सो दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑफ फोरसाइट. नेक्स्ट कम्स बिजनेस मोरालिटी. मोरालिटी मीन्स यू हैव द कैपेसिटी टू मेक ए जज दैट व्हाट इज राइट एंड व्हाट इज रॉन्ग, एंड आफ्टर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट व्हाट इज राइट एंड रॉन्ग, यू मस्ट एक्ट अकॉर्डिंगली. We say that honesty is the best policy. So here, this is the business morality for the businessman. A successful businessman must be honest and sincere towards the consumer, workers, means the employee who are working with the business, suppliers, government, and the public. He must not indulge in unethical business practice just to earn quick gain. He must have the capacity, or he must have the ability to be straightforward that what he is dealing with. He must have the capacity to listen about the words, about his decisions, if the decision is wrong and someone will comment about that, I must have the courage to listen about that. Okay, it is not like that I will only focus on the narrow-minded profit-earning ways. It is to be based upon the morality or on the ethical ways, because ethics is the only way, or honesty is the best policy, which will lead us to be in the race for a very long time. Okay, so business morality is very much necessary. Next comes dependability and consistency. The business should be dependable and consistent in his behavior. Man who places no value on the promise they make will loudly complain when they find that they have lost their social and business standing. See, it is saying that you have to be consistent. If you are saying someone that I will do this work by tomorrow, then you have to keep your words. It is not like that, okay, kehne ke liye to keh diya. Okay, this is not going to work. You have to keep the value of your own promise or of your own words. Then only you can expect it from the others, means from the government or the suppliers or the investors or anyone. But if you are not that consistent in your own words or in your works, then people are not going to trust you anymore. Okay, so promise that are kept past current for more than gold, they should be guarded carefully, issued sparingly, and treated with great respect. The next point is saying about the ability to cooperate. A successful businessman must have the tact and patience and courtesy in order to understand others and to get their cooperation. It is like that we are not going to survive single-handedly here. We have to make friends, we have to deal with others in a very good way. So he must be adept in the art of developing contract and winning friends. Okay, he must be able to adapt himself to change in the environment of business. Means we are saying that he have to be very cooperative, he must have empathy, and he must have possessed a very good communication skill, so that he can influence his employees, or he can create the marketing strategy, he can attract new people. Okay, it is not only that the businessman must have the skill to earn more profit or to produce new product or the development things. Okay, the businessman must have to keep a good rapport with others. See, there are already competitors in the market. Okay, and now if you will not create, or if you will not build a good relationship with all the people who are existing already in the market, they will become your enemies. Then you could not focus on your business. There will be no peace, or there will be no harmony. Okay, so you will always stay stressful. That's why we are saying that the businessman must be cooperative towards all the people. Means it can be the shareholders, the investors, or we can say that person have a very long list of people. Okay, and that's why he can create his customer base, or we can say that he will be a successful businessman. How we are saying this? Because we know that with his communication skill, he can influence people. Okay, so this is also very important, that the businessman must have to be cooperative, or he have the ability to cooperate with others. Next is your self-confidence. When we go for any exam also, we are also told that have that self-confidence and don't have the overconfidence. Yes or no? And this confidence is always very much useful, or very essential for anyone to be successful in their life. So self-confidence is a very important quality of a successful businessman. It is reflected in the courage, enthusiasm, leadership ability. A person who lacks confidence in himself cannot inspire others for hard work. If I don't know that how to perform the task, or if I am not confirmed, or if I am not that much of confident that this is going to work, then how I will motivate others? So a successful businessman himself must have possessed self-confidence and a high degree of self-confidence. So self-confidence enable a businessman to ride over troubles. See, there are a lot of risks, there are uncertainties, or there are hurdles we are going to face in our day-to-day life throughout the year. But we must have the courage to face them and for that we need self-confidence that yes, whatever may come, we can face it and we can go forward. So it will keep moving or it will keep pushing the businessman to go until the goal is achieved. The next point is saying that the aptitude for research and analysis. Analytical ability and scientific outlook are essential for success in the business. We have already started that the foresight is very much important. Foresight means that we have the capacity that what we want to achieve in the future and how that foresight will be effective. If we have that aptitude for research and analysis, okay, we can calculate the risk or we can calculate the opportunities and we can analyze the things, then only we can be successful. So from that analysis or the research, we can take the new opportunity and we will create the innovation. That's why it is saying that an aptitude for innovation and creativity helps in making improvement in the product and services so that the society derive greater utility from them. And the last point about the successful businessman is that he must have possess a winning personality. An impressive personality is a great asset to a businessman. It is not like that a successful businessman is taught. We can just polish you. We could not make you. They are born. These are the born qualities almost. Okay. So a person with a charming and cheerful disposition can easily influence and win people. Winning personality consists of self-discipline. These are the characteristics that what are the traits with whom we can say that he has a winning personality. So those traits are your self-discipline, sound physique, presence of mind, a sound moral character, sense of justice, honor, dignity, grace, tact, and patience. And there are many more. Okay, so these are some of those qualities. So with these, we can say that if a businessman must have maximum to maximum of the qualities that we have already studied in this class, then we can say that yes, he is going to be a very successful businessman. Maybe he could not succeed in the next 1 year or 2 years, but in the long term, he is going to be very to very successful businessman. So with this, we have completed our first chapter. So I have just small questions. So let's try this. These are only the true and false statement. Okay. So first is taking photograph of a mountain taking photograph of a mountain as a hobby is an economy activity. This is true or false? So this is actually false. Okay. Because economy activity normally involve with earning profit and this is not only the satisfaction of yourself, that is to be very continuous in the nature and from that you have to earn your livelihood. Because you are taking the photograph only because of the hobby of yourself, then no, this is not an economic activity. Okay. Next is running a hair cutting salon is a business. This is true. Okay, so the second one is true. Third is occupation of doctors, lawyers and chartered accountant are called as profession. This is true. Okay, because they are not dealing with any goods, physical goods. They are providing us the service and this is their profession. So this is true. Next is a business activity may be without a profit motive. A business activity must have a primary objective to earn profit. So if it is without profit, then no, this is not going to be true. So this statement is false. The last one is business involves creation of utility. So yes, this is true because business involves your creation utility. It is your time utility, form utility and your place utility. So you can comment that how much you have secured from this 5, okay, out of 5, how much is your correct answer. With this, I am ending the video lecture class here. In the next class, we are going to start the second chapter. If you have any doubt at any point of the video, you can write it in the comment box. I will answer there. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.